But every joint we can perform.
Okay.
Left joint, outer joint, even between operations, the word which is starting with the A letter, everything
okay.
we can perform.
All conditions.
Yes, all the conditionality will be satisfied.
Okay.
Okay. Now I am going to show you how to debug the web part. Generally,
okay.
to debug the web part, what are the keywords we'll use generally in ASP.NET? Like F10, next F11, next F5.
Right.
Okay. So what is the use of F10, F11, F5?
Like F5 is executing code without debugging.
Yeah, okay.
Right. F10 is line by line and F11 is F10 is jumping the functions.
Yeah.
Like it won't go to the function. But if we use F11, like it will go to each function or method.
Yes, exactly. Perfect.
Right.
See, I have two methods. Assume that void some ABC. Okay. Assume that we have some line of the code.
Okay.
Okay. In between, if you have called one more method, that is XYZ method.
Okay.
Okay. After that, assume one more method. Mention that. Void XYZ.
Okay.
Okay. See, if you are pressing F11,
mm-hmm.
What is the F11? What is the use of F11? It will include even methods also.
Right.
Okay. It will do line by line execution. When this method came into the picture, again directly the cursor will be jumped to this method.
Right.
It will complete the execution of this code. Again it will back to our main method. Complete the rest of the code execution.
Right.
Got it?
Right.
Yeah, that is the use of F11. F10 means it won't care about methods. Okay, directly it will jump the methods.
Methods, yeah.
Getting, whenever method came into the picture, it won't go to this cursor to respect to method.
Mm-hmm.
Instead of that, directly it will get executed rest of the code.
Right.
Okay, rest of the code it will get executed.
Mm-hmm.
Getting?
Yes.
Any doubt?
That's fine.
Yeah. F11 means, see, whenever your cursor would be here, assume that, this line, okay, when you press F5, rest of the code, it will,
it will
come
get
out,
executed.
Yeah, it will come out from the execution of the code,
right,
without executing rest of the code.
Correct.
Yeah. See, how can you debug it? I am using same coding, file, new, project.
We can continue with the old code also.
Yeah. Like debug. Okay, deploy as a form solution, finish it.
Okay.
Next, right click, add new item. I am giving visual web part. Debug. Click on OK. Okay, design. Same. Drag and drop one button. Right click, get left. Okay, click on here.
Okay.
Mention the same method. Using system.data. Using system.data.sql. Giving grid view 1.0. data source. Bind. Got it. Now, how can you debug this coding? See, generally, as of now, rightly deploy the code and testing the functionality. Okay, we are not sure if something goes wrong in between these lines, how we can debug? Yeah, how can you verify it? Finding the solution is very difficult. If you debug line by line execution, easily we can identify the problem, right? Whether parameters are coming or not, whatever the parameters if you give, it is taking the value or not, it is returning the value or not, everything we can figure it out. Okay, now okay. Click on breakpoints wherever you want. Now click on what? Start button. When you start, click on start button, all the SharePoint DLLs will be loaded to what? Our current SharePoint application. It will get open one more window.
Okay.
I am repeating, when I click on start button, one more browser will be open by loading all the DLLs. All the DLLs means SharePoint DLLs, exe files, supporting files, everything will be loaded to new browser.
Okay.
These all the DLLs will be loaded to new browser temporarily. When you stop debugging, the newly opened window will get closed, then everything will be released. Will be released means whatever DLL exe file loaded to new browser, no? These DLL exe files will get released.
Okay.
Got it. Even this web part also will be deployed to our web application temporarily. When we stop the debugging, it will delete it. That web part will be deleted from the SharePoint.
Okay.
All the DLL will be released from the existing SharePoint application. If you want permanent deployment, right click on deploy.
Okay.
Got it. Now click on start button. See, one more browser will get open by loading all the DLLs temporarily. Temporarily keyword is very, 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 very important. See, click on OK. See, deployment succeeded. What does it mean? Temporarily it is deployed.
Yeah, no.
Not permanently.
What that pop-up came? It is asking to change some web config?
No. You want to run this thing or not? That's all.
Yeah, but will it do any changes in web config?
No. Nothing. Debugging equal to true, it will make changes.
Oh, that's it. Okay.
Without debugging true, it won't, we cannot debug, right? Even .NET also same.
Okay. Fine.
It is taking time. Why it is taking time? All the DLLs, exe files should be loaded to new browser.
Right.
Okay. New browser means temporarily. This file should be loaded. See, one more window got open.
Okay.
Pass the things. Administrator. Test it 1, 2, 3.
Yeah, one question, like what you said is like the deployment will be temporary, right?
Yes.
When we are debugging. But if we are already deployed the things and we place the those web parts on our pages in SharePoint.
Yeah.
Okay. And then later on we are doing some changes in that web part and want to debug it. So that time how it will happen?
Yeah, same. Newly changes, whatever happened, no? According to that, it will open the browser.
Okay. So that means the old web part, what we are doing changes on that, will remain as it is on the page, right?
Yeah, as it is in the page. Okay. Until unless you are deploying permanently.
Okay, means after debugging, again, we can say the old functionality if we are using, we are seeing that in SharePoint.
Yes, yes.
Okay.
Generally in real time, how many environments are there? One is dev,
right.
Staging
and production. Right.
Anyhow, dev environment is under control of developers.
Right.
Okay. So for stage and production, who will have the access? Developer will be having the access?
No.
No. Okay. See, development, upper development end, development mission, we can say R&D purpose.
Right.
Yeah, testing the functionality. Sorry, do the R&D something about some functionality, implement. If it is everything fine, we will move this function to stage. Stage will be tested out by what? Testers. If it is working fine, then finally we will move into view here. So it doesn't make a sense, you know, whatever you are doing over here.
Okay. So like deployment, right? Yeah.
Yes, yes. Okay, temporary browser. Now, click on edit. I told you, the web part got deployed temporarily.
Right.
Okay, click on insert. Okay, click on web part.
Okay.
Custom. What is it?
Yes, the debug.
Debug, yeah. Click on off.
Okay.
Click on save.
Right.
When I click on debug, immediately the cursor will be jumped to in this area.
Right.
Okay. Immediately the cursor will go to where? Our Visual Studio. Mm-hmm. Click on get data.
Okay.
See? Got it? As of now, what is it? It null. Connection value is null. No. Nothing was there.
Right. That's true.
Okay. Yeah. Now click on F11. It will go to next time. Hmm. What is it connection now? We got some parameters.
Right.
Expand it. Timeout. Connection timeout is 15
seconds. Yeah.
What is the connection string? Click on this bad symbol. What is it? Data source. Our SQL server name.
Right.
Initial catalog. Our database name. Integrated security is true.
Correct.
Okay. Yeah. Next. What is the S value? It is null.
Null. Yeah.
Okay. Click on F11. Now it is select star from EMP.
Alright.
Got it? If you get executed this command in SQL server.
Yes, we will get the values.
We will get the value.
Right.
See? Got it?
Right.
So, next. What this statement we do? As of now it is DMP value is null.
Null, yeah.
Click on F11. This statement got executed. So,
true.
What this statement will do? It will carry the what? Connection parameter as well as string parameters.
Yeah.
To SQL server, the value get executed against of database. Got it? Now data is ready. Where? In SQL server side.
Hmm.
Got it?
Yes.
Now I have taken the empty data set. What is this data set?
Yes.
Null.
Null, yeah.
Click on F11. What is it? Now,
yes.
Click on this bad symbol. Empty data. Hmm. It is empty data set.
Yes.
Nothing is there. Now, I want fill this data set with what? SQL data.
Right.
Okay. Now, what is it? DA.fill.
Right.
What I am filling? Data set. If we click on next, the command got executed. The data set filled with what? Some data. Just see.
Right.
we got this data or not.
Right.
Okay. If something is wrong, will it execute it? No. If there is a problem with consisting of this parameter, will you get any that output?
No.
No. Directly it will show there is a problem with something.
Okay.
Okay. Click on again F11. F11. See, refreshing, we will get the data.
Right.
Got it?
Right.
Now, what I am doing is, see, all these DLLs got loaded. EXE file, master page, everything.
Right.
Got it? Now, when I stop debugging, okay, all the DLLs, see, all the exe file, Java file, everything got loaded currently. When you stop debugging, then the deployed, newly deployed web part also, it will be retracked. Retracted means deleted from SharePoint application. Got it?
Okay, yes.
Yeah. Click on stop debugging. Okay. See, that browser has been opened IE. Now it was not there.
Right. It
got it?
Yeah.
Yeah. Now go there. Our web application. If I see that web part, will it be there or not?
No.
No, it won't
should
be,
not
there.
Be there. See? Yeah.
Yeah. Verify it if required. Why? Because I didn't deploy.
Right. It got refreshed, I guess.
Now click on edit, click on insert, click on web part, custom.
Is there?
See, what is it?
Okay.
The operation could not be completed because this item is removed gallery. Got it.
But why it is showing there then?
Showing, but that web part not a deployed. The name it is showing just. See, when I add it, what is showing?
Yeah, yeah, it is giving message.
Yeah. But the name it is displaying. But functionality wise, it was not there. That web part was not there.
Okay.
Okay, see here. The operation could not be completed because of this item was removed from gallery.
Right.
That means it is retracted the solution.
Right.
Okay. The web part entire thing it is retracked, but name was existing, that's all.
Correct.
Okay. Any doubt?
No. It's fine.
Yeah. This is about what? How to debug the web part.
Okay.
Yeah. Now tell me, you know page life cycle, right?
Yes.
Yeah. What is the page life cycle?
That is initialize, then load.
Yeah. Init. Next page load.
Page load.
Yeah. Load. Next. Pre-render.
Pre-render.
Yeah. Render.
Render.
Next. B state save.
अरे नीचे टाइप करो ना रे जिसको आंसर आता है.
Got it.
Notepad में.
What else?
Render, view saved, I don't remember now.
Yeah. Init, load, pre-render, render, view state, save. Next. Dispose.
Okay.
Okay. Next, unload the page. getting?
Yes.
Yeah, same way there are Peppard life cycle. Very important interview question.
Okay.
Direct question they will ask you, what is the Peppard life cycle?
Okay.
Okay, that time okay. We will discuss it in tomorrow.
Okay.
That is session. Then after that we will go for SharePoint designer.
Okay,
got it?
Fine.
Yeah. I'm stopping here. Okay. Just be online. I will send this recording.
Okay, sure.
Yeah. I'm also getting late for office.
Yeah.